In India, the role of opinion leaders and patients in helping the government recognize the potentials of the homeopathy has been immense. Even our renowned leader Mahatma Gandhi once expressed, homeopathy cures a greater percentage of the cases than any other method of the treatment. Homeopathy is the latest and refined method of the treating the patient economically and non-violently. Of course, India has been blessed with some exceptionally skillful homeopathic practitioners too, whose work brought a lot of credibility to the system back in early 20th century. From then to today, homeopathy has come a long way. Indian homeopathic practitioners are sought after across the globe for providing online treatment, teaching, and even software development. Our researchers from different walks of science, like physicists, molecular biologists, chemists, and even genetic experts are joining the hands with homeopathy researchers to unveil the at-explored part of the homeopathy using the latest scientific knowledge, know-how and technology. As the country with the maximum number of homeopathy doctors and patients, I can assure you, India is here to provide all the support through my ministry for the development of the homeopathy in the world. We can initiate dialogues at regular level with your country. We can mobilize exports of made in India homeopathic drugs to your region through bilateral efforts. We can provide you the technical support in capacity building and infrastructure strengthening of homeopathy in your country. Further, we welcome with open arms those international manufacturers who are willing to open their manufacturing plants in India under Making India policy of our Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Bhai Modi ji. We committed to provide all kinds of support for this endeavor. My ministry is actively taking the painstaking efforts for enabling the international atmosphere in favor of AYUSH system. We have established 26 AYUSH information cells in the 24 countries for dissemination of authentic information. Our research council is proactively interacting with the reputed institutions, universities for joint research projects. So far, MOUs have been signed with the National Polytechnic Institution, Mexico, Royal London Hospital for Integrated Medicine, part of University College of London Hospital, NHS Foundation Trust, UK, Erwin State Medical University, Armenia, College of Homeopathic of Ontario, Canada, and with the University of Manmon Dizais in Argentina. Today, it has been my honor to pleasure to witness this proud occasion of signing of Memorandum of Understanding amongst the Homeopathic Pharmacopoeia Convention of this United States and Indian bodies. Pharmacopoeia's Commission of the Indian Medicine and Homeopathy and Central Council of Research in Homeopathy on cooperation in the field of homeopathic medicine. I truly hope this agreement will be a benchmark for the many more agreements to follow with the aim to develop the harmonized homeopathic pharmacopoeia and strengthen and enable regulatory provision for homeopathic in the whole world. Friends, India is in a position and is willing to take the initiative to head start talk with the drug regulatory agencies in various countries to achieve the regulatory harmony for homeopathic medicine. As host to this unique forum, I can assure you we seek this endeavor only as a stepping stone for making the homeopathy a more accessible system in the world. I eagerly wait to see the outcomes of this forum and would take the keen interest to materialize the deliberations proposed during these 2 days by experts from regulatory industry and pharmacopoeia side. With this word, I thank you once again. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, Honorable Minister, sir, for having your concern on the various concerns of the science, the practice, and the medicine of homeopathy, and extending your assurance towards addressing these, and also towards further development of homeopathy in the world, opening doors for various industries to be part of the Make in India initiative, and also towards developing the R&D in homeopathy. Thank you so very much, sir, for your guidance and for all the support. And as we conclude the inaugural session, I would now like to request Dr. Anil Khurana, the Deputy Director General of CCRH, to kindly propose a formal vote of thanks.
Thank you. It's a great honor and privilege for me to be called upon to propose a vote of thanks on the occasion of this World Integrated Medicine Forum on the regulations of homeopathic medicine products, national and global strategies. The first ever kind of event in the homeopathic parlance. It has been said that opportunities are on every hand. What we need is not a new chance, but a clarity of the vision to discover the chance, which at this very hour is ours if we recognize it. Now, CCRH is committed to overall growth and development of homeopathy, including scientific upgradation, educational quality, and pharmacopoeial technology. Under the able leadership of Sri Sripad Naik ji, Honorable Minister of Ayush, we have been given this opportunity to extend our horizons from within the country to all parts of the world. Sir, we are highly grateful to you for your gracious presence today, which is a testimony of Indian government's deep commitment to strengthen the homeopathic system of medicine. I assure you, sir, that all the countries will join hands to meet the emerging challenges in the present global scenario and will contribute towards improving the quality standards of homeopathic medicine and related matters. I also convey heartfelt thanks to Shri Ajit Mohan Sharan ji, Honorable Secretary, Ministry of Ayush, for his stewardship, vision, and commitment for promoting international cooperation. Your valuable guidance has given CCRH a new impetus to its work. I would also like to thank Shri Anil Kumar Ganeriwala ji, Joint Secretary, under whose facilitation and able guidance, we were able to develop this idea of a meet into a full-fledged international forum with representatives from 25 countries across 5 continents. At the same time, I take this opportunity to thank Professor S.S. Handa, an inspirational force in streamlining the pharmacopoeial work for Ayush sector and for continued guidance. Thanks are also extended to officers and staff of Ministry of Ayush and to Shri Ranjit Kumar ji, Joint Secretary, who could not be here because of some other reasons. The officers and staff at Ministry have supported us in undertaking this very challenging task beyond the traditional boundaries of core research for the cause of homeopathy. And I'm particularly thankful to Dr. Robert Haslin for instilling this vision to us. We had been actively contributing, he has been actively contributed to the CCRH and played an important role in harmonizing the drug proving protocol of the Council in the past in line with the international guidance. Thank you, sir. Dr. Manchanda, our Director General, thought it to be an opportune time to for undertaking this forum, bringing the industry and the stake regulators and at the same platform for overall development of the pharmaceutical industry, particularly in an inclusive manner. I thank you, sir, for continued guidance to us. I am thankful to you all to have chosen to come here in the meet to better appreciate the concerns of each other and work on possible solutions together for the benefit of the industry and its consumers in entire spectrum. Thank you for sparing your valuable time reaching all from different parts of the globe. We also have homeopathic experts, practitioners, academicians, researchers, and our senior committee members and expert group members who have always shown us the way forward in spite of any adversities coming towards homeopathy in India or abroad. This event has been organized and hosted by our Ashoka Hotel and Ashoka Events Indian Tourism Development Corporation. I fully appreciate the hard work and relentless pursuits of the officers and staff of the CCRH. I will call upon them to just come and stay behind our minister, starting from the very behind, two are there on the dais, Dr. Manchanda and Dr. Robert Haslin, Dr. Sundaram, Mr. Kaushik, and the entire team, Dr. Anupriya, Harleen, Renu, Ritika, please come, just stay behind the ministers, to Dr. Divya, Dr. Suniti, please. giant behind the stage. So this was a small team which was working since last 2-3 months for magicians. And since this is, I thank you all, I'm also joining with them. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir, and congratulations to the entire team. And now we have the group photograph of all of you with the Honorable Minister. As earlier stated, the first row dignitaries are requested to please join us here. The second row dignitaries are requested to remain in the hall. The third and the fourth can move out for tea. And then later join us, have your quick tea and join us back for the group photograph. We're just rearranging the head table for the group photograph. So the first row and the second row, you are requested to remain in the hall. The third and fourth, join us for tea. The group photograph which we are taking right now is going to be extended to you tomorrow morning. You can take it from the registration desk. It is for all of you. Each one of you is going to be individually presented the group photograph tomorrow morning, which you can collect from the registration desk.